Hello my dear students, in this lecture we are going to understand pure substance and Gibbs phase rule concept. Now here, pure substance, make a note that pure substance is nothing but pure substance is a substance having same chemical composition throughout its volume of mixture. Means chemical formula is same, chemical composition is same means chemical formula is same. It may exist in more than one phase, right? Let us understand the examples here. Example here, ice is pure substance. Ice is pure substance. What is the chemical formula of ice? H2O, right? It is a pure substance. Only water is also pure substance. What is the chemical formula of water? H2O. Again, water vapor, that is steam. Water vapor is called steam. It is also pure substance. What is chemical formula? H2O. Now here, if I do ice plus water plus steam, that is water vapor. Steam is nothing but water vapor. Ice plus water vapor. Now for ice, water as well as water vapor, the chemical composition is same. Therefore, the mixture is also pure substance. The mixture is also pure substance. Ice plus water vapor is also pure substance. Therefore, it is written that the pure substance, it may exist in more than one phase. See here, there are three phases. Now, in previous lecture, we have seen triple point of water. Right. Triple point is a point where substance exists in solid, liquid as well as gaseous phase. And therefore, for water, the water exists in ice as well as water as well as vapor state. Therefore, triple point of water is under pure substance, pure phase condition or pure substance. At triple point of water, what I am saying, triple point of water is pure substance, right? These are the various pure substance. Again, dry air. Again, one more example, dry air. My dear students, dry air means that is only air. The meaning is only air. It is a pure substance again. But my dear students, the atmospheric air is not a pure substance. Again, air plus petrol vapor. We can say air plus petrol vapor. This is pure substance. My dear students, air plus petrol vapor is a pure substance. Now, let us understand who are not pure substances. Let us understand the examples, those which are not pure substances. For example, air plus liquid air. Here, the composition is not chemically homogeneous. Right. Means same chemical composition is not there. Therefore, this is not a pure substance. Again, air plus diesel vapor. Air plus petrol vapor is pure substance, but air plus diesel vapor is not a pure substance. Again, atmospheric air. My dear students, atmospheric air is not a pure substance. Now, my dear students, atmospheric air means it is a mixture of dry air plus water vapor. Right. Any air is having water molecules in the form of vapor as well as dry air. And the study of atmospheric air, that is dry air plus water vapor, is called psychometry. And this is our topic of syllabus, right? Now, in psychometry, we will learn how to study atmospheric air. But my dear students, air is nothing but oxygen plus nitrogen. And here in air, there is a 79% nitrogen plus 21% oxygen. And my dear students, water vapor is nothing but H2O. Means it is chemically, the chemical composition is not same throughout, right? Therefore, atmospheric air is not a pure substance because, my dear students, in some places, the water molecules present in air are different magnitude, right? You will study relative humidity concept, specific humidity concept in psychometry topic. If you go to the coastline area, then near coastline area, near sea level, there will be a relative humidity is very high. At sea level, the relative humidity is very high. That means there are more water molecules in the dry air. But in other areas, such as in, let us say, deserts, there will be a more dry air. And in sea level, in near sea, there will be a more water vapor. Therefore, this percentage of dry air and water vapor are varying at location to location. Hence, atmospheric air is considered as not a pure substance. And my dear students, whenever it is a pure substance, the pure substance is considered as single component. What I am saying, the pure substance is considered as single component, right? Whenever it is a pure substance, Now water at triple point, that is water ice plus water vapor, is a pure substance, and pure substance is considered as single component. Single component, right? Now my dear students, after that we will understand Gibbs phase rule. The next point is Gibbs phase rule, and there are many chances to ask question on this phase rule, Gibbs phase rule. Now Gibbs phase rule says that F plus P is equal to C plus 2. This is your Gibbs phase rule. And my dear students, in this F plus P is equal to C plus 2, let us understand the meaning of various parameter. Now here F is nothing but degree of freedom, which is nothing but, that is number of independent parameters required to specify the state of system. Degree of freedom is also defined as number of independent parameters required to specify the state of system. Now again, this P is nothing but number of phases. Phases means there will be a solid phase, there will be a liquid phase, there will be a vapor phase. These are the various three phases, right? And C is nothing but number of components, right? And my dear students, we have already stated that pure substance is considered as single component, right? Now let us see the questions on this. Now on Gibbs phase rule, let us understand the questions. Let us say question number one is find degree of freedom at triple point of water. Now my dear students, triple point is a point where substance exists in solid, liquid as well as vapor state. Therefore at triple point of water, the water exists in ice plus water plus vapor also, water vapor also means we have to find degree of freedom at triple point of water where number of phases are 3. At triple point of water it is having 3 phases, that is ice plus water plus vapor. But triple point of water is a pure substance, therefore number of component is equal to 1 only. Therefore apply Gibbs phase rule, F plus P is equal to C plus 2. Therefore F is equal to C plus 2 minus P, which is equal to C is 1 plus 2 minus 3, which is equal to 0. Therefore degree of freedom at triple point of water is 0. Because of this point is fixed. Degree of freedom is 0 means number of independent coordinates required to specify the state of system are 0. Means this point is always in fixed location. This point will not change its position. Hence this triple point of water is reference point for the temperature measurement. Reference point for, we can say, temperature measurement. In previous lecture we have studied this triple point concept, right? Again they will ask you, what will be the degree of freedom in liquid vapor dome for water? Question: find degree of freedom in liquid vapor dome, right? Now here for water, now here ice plus water plus vapor is a pure substance. Therefore here water plus vapor, liquid means water, vapor means vapor, steam, right? Therefore it is a pure substance, therefore it is a single component. But phases are 2, and what is degree of freedom? Now put the formula, F plus P is equal to C plus 2. Therefore F is equal to C is 1 plus 2 and P is minus 2, which is equal to 1. Therefore in a two state region for water, degree of freedom is 1. In two state region for water, degree of freedom is 1. Now let us find, again they will ask you, what is the degree of freedom in single state region? Question: for water in single state region find degree of freedom. What is degree of freedom? It may be a solid state only, it may be a liquid state only, or it may be a vapor state only. That means number of phases is equal to 1, and it is a pure substance. Water is a pure substance, therefore number of components is equal to 1, and degree of freedom is ? Therefore F plus P is equal to C plus 2. Therefore F is equal to C is 1 plus 2 minus P is 1. Therefore degree of freedom is equal to 2. Therefore in two single state region, degree of freedom for the water is 2. In two state region, degree of freedom is 1, and at a triple point, degree of freedom for the water is 0. Thank you dear students. In next lecture we will see vapor pressure curve.